Anyway, we add 10 and 10 to 228. That gives us 248. Subtract 90 from that, and that gives us 158. So that's the first number of our combination.
Congratulations. You better hurry up and get the other two, because you have, a half an hour left.
A half hour?
Mm-hmm.
How can that be? We haven't been here for over an hour.
Nah. We can't be a team without trust.
Why are you being so difficult?
Trust game.
No.
Oh, that's just perfect. You would rather argue than save your friend's life. That is so selfish. So pathetic. I'd expect more from you, Emily. You know, you really hurt me. You disappointed me. Pags is hurting. On the inside. I don't have therapy money. I have feelings too. And I'm not feeling good.
Welcome back, boxing fans. Let's get ready to rumble. In this corner we have Redfish. He's a crafty southpaw from the mighty Mississippi. And in this corner we have
Rocky Balboa. I really want to fight. I'm going to eat the fish alive. I'm going to make sushi out of him. That's funny. Okay. Emily!
I'm sensing hostility here. If you don't want to play fish boxing, just let me know.
Can I read this now?
Sure. Go right ahead.
See, one fish, two fish, red fish, blue fish. Find the weight of the blue fish.
I don't suppose that would do.
No, I don't see a blue fish.
Ooh, I'll be right back.
Add the weight to the fish's crate once you know how much it can capacitate. Then the second number will cast your fate. Great, can't even find the fish, let alone the crate it came in.
Blue fish.
It's blue.
Let's weigh that sucker. That fish weighs 4 tons.
It doesn't weigh 4 tons. A ton is 2,000 pounds. If it weighed that much, you would not be able to carry it.
I think I could. I think I could carry the 4-ton fish. I've been working out. I've been doing squat thrusts.
Yeah, right. So the fish weighs 4 pounds.
Now that seems like way too large a number.
4?
Maybe the scale reads ounces.
No, there are 16 ounces in a pound. 4 ounces would be too small. I think it's safe to assume that the fish is 4 pounds.
Maybe we should try that metric stuff you like so much. Maybe the scale is metric.
I don't think so. The main unit in the metric system for weight is a gram, and that's about the weight of a paperclip.
And you think the fish weighs more?
Yeah, it's just like with length. You add the number of prefixes that increase or decrease the metric unit by a power of 10. The most common would be the milligram, which is 1/1000th the weight of a gram. And there's the kilogram, which is 1,000 times the weight of a gram. The milligram is probably the weight of a fly's wing, and the kilogram is the weight of an encyclopedia.
Okay, we'll stick with 4 pounds then. Is that okay with you?
That's fine. Okay, now we need to find the capacity of the crate, but it never came in a crate. That'll work. If we can paint a fish blue, we can use a paint can to use it as a crate that it came in.
Yes, we can. Capacity. Now what? That's like liters, right?
Well, sure, in metric units, but the capacity of the bucket would be in standard units.
Are you sure?
Yeah, it says 1 gallon right on it.
So, there's no, like, milliliters or, like, kiloliter?
There is. We buy soda in 2-liter bottles. And a milliliter would be what an eyedropper holds. And a kiloliter would be about the size of a large wading pool.
Boring! Boy, 1 gallon. You know what? What if I just wanted a cup, huh? Just 1 cup of paint with my morning coffee. Paint and coffee. Good. How many cups is that?
Okay, 1 gallon is 16 cups. A cup is 8 fluid ounces. And there's 2 cups in a pint, 2 pints in a quart, and 4 quarts in a gallon.
I'm sorry, you were just boring me to death. You know, I've got one of these.
Cool.
Very.
We know the fish weighs 4 pounds, and the capacity of the bucket is 1 gallon. Mm-hmm. So we take those two numbers and add them together, although you'd actually not add gallons and pounds together in real life, And we get the second number of our combination, which is 5.
You better hurry up, though. You've got 1 minute left.
What?
Yeah.
Okay, now that your quest has nearly come to an end, you need one more number to save your friend. To ensure that his heart continues beating, you must find the room's temperature reading.
Okay. Let's see, it's 32 degrees.
32? It's not that cold.
32 degrees Celsius, not Fahrenheit. 32 is the magic number. Have fun saving your friend. You know, Fish, in Celsius, 0 is freezing. That's how they measure it. Yep, freezing is 0 in Celsius. Then boiling is 100. That's right. Now in Fahrenheit, freezing is 32 degrees, and then they measure boiling at 212. I know, hard to believe, but guess what? I'll tell you. Here we measure temperature in Fahrenheit. It's astounding. I'm making up my own language.
What are you doing?
What's up, Emily? Did you get the dip?
What are you talking about? I thought you were in danger. I've been running around this place like mad trying to rescue you.
What are you talking about? You've been in there the whole time, Emily.
No, I haven't. And quit calling me Emily. My name is Chris. This isn't funny anymore.
Why are you getting so upset? Here, have some chips. What? Huh?
In this program, we discussed how to add and subtract units of time. We also discussed several other units used for measuring. To measure length, we use inches, feet, yards, or miles, or millimeters, centimeters, meters, and kilometers in the metric system. Area and volume are measured using the same units as length, except that they are squared for area, such as square feet, and cubed for volume, such as cubic meters. The unit of measure for an angle is the degree. For measuring weight, ounces, pounds, and tons are the customary units, while milligrams, grams, and kilograms are the metric units. When measuring capacity, we use cups, pints, quarts, and gallons, or milliliters, liters, and kiloliters in the metric system. And finally, we learned about two systems used to measure temperature. Celsius, where water freezes at 0 degrees and boils at 100 degrees, and Fahrenheit, where water freezes at 32 degrees and boils at 212 degrees. Mmm, delightful.
One heart I reached for you. I knew your youth was for the taking. Fire on the metal plane, so I ran through the fields as the bats with their baby vain faces burst from the barn in flames in the violet, violent sky. And I fell on my knees and pressed you against me. Your skull was like a network of spittle, like glass balls moving in like cold streams of logic. And our blade is that lightning attack that some will make go crack. Some will